Hello. I think you know it's time for our Christmas lecture this year. So let's get started.
We used these cookies to visualize important aspects in axial spondyloarthritis. We focus on the vertebral bodies with its anterior sides at the corners of the vertebral bodies. We did also take note of the pedicles, the facet joints, and also the spinous processes. Our special interest were syndesmophytes that are bony outgrowths of the vertebral body due to the inflammation at the anterior side. And we also stressed that there is predominantly fatty tissue within the syndesmophytes at later stages because there is repair tissue within these bony outgrowths. So what should we do this year?
So let's open the next chapter in this year's Christmas lecture. But I think you know that as a radiologist, you need some decent coffee to work. So let's go get some coffee.
I don't like to use cookies again for this year's lecture. Rather, I would like to try something new. And you guessed it already. This coffee mug is our canvas today for the lecture. And on this coffee mug, there are printed four different scenes that are summarizing important concepts of sacroiliitis as it occurs in axial spondyloarthritis. So let's get started. In the first scene, we see the basic anatomy of the sacroiliac joint. And over here, we see the sacral bone with its neuroforamen. We can see the ilium on the opposite side. We see the joint cleft. As you can see, inflammation occurs on both sides of the joint. As it is visualized here in the lower part of the sacroiliac joint, we see there is a larger side of bone marrow edema visualized in red over here, with a corresponding smaller lesion on the opposite bone in the ilium. But not all patients are showing up with these corresponding lesions. Some patients only have bone marrow edema on just one side of the bone. Also, you see that in this early phase of the disease, we may see also small erosions already, which are very important for differential diagnosis, as a certain number of other diseases do not represent with erosions.
Going to the next stage, and here's already a lot of things to be seen. You see there is now bone sclerosis. This bone sclerosis, there is usually some sclerosis at the upper edge of the joint cleft, which is physiological. Here we have pronounced sclerosis that is a feature of sacroiliitis. And you also see that there are now more erosions at the joint contours. So during the course of the disease, more erosions are developing. And these are small defects in the contour of the bone. You see also that the red area here has now been exchanged with a yellow area, which represents fatty changes, so fat deposition inside the bone marrow, which means the bone marrow that was inflamed gets transformed into fat lesions, and this is more or less a repair tissue in the bone marrow. This repair tissue which contains fat, can be seen both in the sacral bone and also in the iliac bone. And it might be next to erosions, but sometimes you see it also disconnected from erosions. Also, you see some tiny spot of red here over here. This shows us that sometimes we have a mixture of active lesions, which are represented as bone marrow edema, together with lesions that are already transformed into fatty areas. Okay, so the third stage is very interesting, and a lot of things are to be seen in the third stage of chronic sarcoiditis. So let's have a closer look. So now, compared to the second stage, where we have the joint space merely as a cleft between the bones, we have now a representation of the articular cartilage as a blue area. And if you look carefully, we have now even more erosions. If you compare it again to the second stage, here where there are some singular erosions, maybe about six of them or five of them. And here we have many more erosions, and they are located next to each other, which means that the joint space is now wider than normal, which is called a pseudo-widening of the joint space. And also we can now look what's inside the erosion. We see now there is this green to yellow substance inside the erosions. And this is again a sign of repair tissue, but now it's not in the bone marrow. Now it's in the erosions themselves. And this is called backfill, or it's called fat metaplasia in an erosion cavity. If you look carefully, you can see that sclerosis is even larger now, and there are some small irregularities in the joint space, and these are the so-called bone buds. So this is early ankylosis, that are small ossification centers that are growing from one side of the joint to the next, but they have not reached the other side. So they are called bone buds in this stage. And also you can see that this side of erosion cavity and backfill, there are some small dots inside, which are showing us that there are some ossification centers also in these areas. And also the yellow area in the bone marrow is now becoming larger, which shows us that the fat metaplasia is taking over in the bone marrow. Okay, what else do we have? We have the fourth stage, which is now almost ankylosis. It's not full ankylosis, but here in this picture you can see the nature of ankylosis. So you can see, if, especially if you compare it with the third stage, that sclerosis is now going back again. We see the joint space is no longer visible. It is now a faint line because these bone buds have taken over. And so there's ankylosis in the upper part. We have maybe some residual joint space here in the middle part. And we have also bony ossification centers in the lower part. And there's also ankylosis already here. And if you compare the fat metaplasia, fatty lesions, there were some large areas here, and now almost all of the bone is taken over by the fat lesions, and these fat lesions are usually a sign of repair and of development of new tissue, but it's usually not normal bone marrow, it's not hematopoietic bone marrow, it is fatty bone marrow, and we call it fat lesions in axial spondyloarthritis. Okay, so I hope you get your own coffee and your own cup to learn. Maybe if you are an academic teacher, you use it to teach your students. And if you are only a few times a year seeing patients with axial spondyloarthritis, maybe then this cup is also of value for you, because when you get your coffee, you know about what's going on in the sacroiliac joints. Okay, so I hope this was fun to watch. It was for me definitely fun to do these cups. And see you next year. And let's see what next Christmas time will be there in the world of musculoskeletal radiology and learning from us. Thank you and bye bye. And I hope you had some time to make your own cookies and have some delicious cookies on your side as well. Bye bye.